session at Graduate Guru. Till the last session, we were doing revenue accounts of fire insurance companies, marine insurance companies, etc. Now, in this question, in this session, we will be covering profit and loss account also. So, let us read question number 11. From the following balances of Varsha General Insurance Company Limited, prepare revenue accounts and profit and loss account for the year ended 31st March 2020. In case of fire insurance, so there is going to be multiple insurance businesses. So here they've mentioned that for fire insurance, increase the additional reserve by 7.5% of net premium. What does this mean? Jo bhi hamara additional reserve already diya hai, over and above that, I want to add 7.5% of premium to that. That will become my closing reserve. So, we'll see how to calculate this slightly different calculation. This is in addition to the usual reserves. Usual reserves means, hame pata hona chahiye what is the reserve percentage. So, let us read the sum. Let us see what are the businesses, that is insurance businesses, jo hum cover kar rahe hain. Accordingly, we'll decide the rate of reserve. Depreciation is given, interest and dividend received is given, difference in exchange, credit. We had done something similar in the last sum, foreign exchange gain maine aapko karwaya tha. So, this is also other income aur credit diya hai means it's a positive balance. Fire fund, marine fund and these are opening balances, 1st April ke balances hai. Last sum I had explained to you, fund is nothing but your unexpired risk reserve only. Aur yahan par we come to know that fire and marine, ye do businesses ke revenue accounts hame banane hai. Bad debts is given separately for fire and for marine. Auditors fees, directors remuneration, share transfer fees. This is also an income for any company. Jab कोई shareholder अपने shares किसी और को transfer करता है, the company generally collects a charge on that. That is called share transfer fees. So, this is an income. Now, if you'll see all the amounts which we saw, other than the fund and the bad debts, sare amounts were common amounts. We don't know how much is fire, how much is marine. So, that means all these expenses and incomes hum revenue account mein nahi lenge. We will have to take them directly to the profit and loss account. And that is what is different about this sum. First, we will find the operating profit from the two insurance businesses, fire and marine. Then, we will take that operating profit to profit and loss account. And we will find the final profit for the entire company. Then, they've given us for fire department, they've given us outstanding claims, claims paid and outstanding claims on 31st March. So, opening, closing and claims paid. Same way, marine department ke liye bhi, all these things are given. Commission paid is given separately for fire and marine. Then we have additional reserve. Jo humne additional reserve ke baare mein padha tha, obviously it is only for fire. Marine ke liye, there is no additional reserve maintained by this company. Other companies may maintain. Aisa koi strict rule nahi hai. But this company is only maintaining extra additional reserve for fire. So, uska opening balance hai. Miscellaneous receipts. Again, this is a common income for the entire company. And finally, we have premium received. Ek amount diya hai, but in brackets they have said how much is in respect of fire. So, obviously the balance will be for marine. Outstanding premium is given in adjustments as on 31st March, that is our closing outstanding is given. For fire business, 100,000, for marine business, 192,000. And they've also said that we have to provide tax at 30%. Tax again, full company will pay the tax. So, this will come in profit and loss account. So, first we are going to prepare our revenue account just like we do in any other sum. Ab tak humne jo bhi sums kiye, we did our schedules, we prepared our revenue account, found our operating profit. That much part is going to be the same in this sum also. What is different is, after we get our operating profit, hum additional P&L account banane wale hain to find our final profit. So, let us begin the sum with our first schedule, which is always for premium earned. So here there is no adjustment as such given for our reinsurance, etc. There is just one premium received amount given, and then there is outstanding premium. So we'll just write that much, whatever is given to us. So received and add closing outstanding, that is receivable. So first in the received amount which they have given, which is the last item in the list of accounts which they've given us, premium received total is 10,800. Now all these amounts are already in 1,000, so we don't have to slash off any zeros. 10,800 is total premium, out of which 3,600 is for fire. So in the fire column, I will write down 3,600. And balance 10,800 minus 3,600 will go to marine, which is 7,200. Okay, so we've just split the total amount into two parts, fire and marine. Now coming to closing outstanding, the amounts are directly given in our adjustment, 100,000 and 192,000. So 100 and 192. Let's add this, so we get 3,700 and 7,392. This is our net premium. And after this, we do adjustment for unexpired risk. In this sum, it is called fund, but as I said, it is the same. So we are going to do a working note as usual for our unexpired risk. So first let us come to our closing reserve. And in closing reserve, we will first have usual reserve, because that is the word they have used. And we will also have additional reserve. Now this additional reserve itself has a small calculation. Pehle usual reserve. Usual for fire will be 50%. Marine ke liye 100%. Of what? Of your net premiums. So 3700 into 50% for fire. That is 1850. I'll put 0.00 in case we get some decimals. And for marine, it is always 100%. So 7392 for marine. Here, if you don't remember, you can just put it down 50% and 100%. So you'll come to know where we got these amounts from. Now, additional reserve. Marine mein additional reserve hai hi nahi. So I'll put a dash. For fire, what have they said? Let us read the first line again that they gave for additional reserve. In case of fire insurance, increase the additional reserve by 7.5% of net premium. Already additional reserve hai. In our list, we have an additional reserve of 300. So 300 plus I have to increase this by something. So I will add 300 plus, I have to increase it by 7.5% of net premium. Obviously net premium of fire only. So of 3,700. So this is how we will get our closing additional reserve. You have to be very careful. Words kya diye hain in the sum. Accordingly do your calculation. Blindly 7.5% sirf nahi lena hai. They have clearly said increase it. So jo bhi additional reserve hai, usme 7.5% hame add karna hai. So let us calculate this. 3700 into 7.5%, we get 277.5 plus 300. So 577.50. This is our additional reserve. As I said, for marine, there is no additional reserve. So this will give us our total closing reserve. So let us add 577.5 plus 1850. We get 2427.50. This remains as 7392. And now let us see our opening reserves. Opening reserve, first we'll write usual reserve. I'm writing fund in the bracket. Kyunki hamare list mein the item has been given as fund. So fire ke liye the fund is 1500. And for marine, it is 4920. And then we write additional reserve. Additional reserve, humne yahan bhi dekha, it was 300 for fire, nothing for marine. Now let's take a total of our opening reserves. So we have 1800 in fire. 4920 in marine. This is our total opening reserve. And as usual, we have to compare closing with opening and get the difference. That is our adjustment. So 2427.5 minus 1800, we get 627.50. And for marine, 7392 minus 4920, we get 2472. Aur dono hi situation mein closing is more than opening. Closing zyada hai to negative figure in our schedule. So over here I'll write brackets mein 627.50 and 2472. Let us subtract. So 3700 minus 627.5, we get 3072.50, and 7392 minus 2472, we will get 4920. This is what we will take to our revenue account. So 3072.50 and 4920. So this is our premium earned. Now we have profit or loss on sale, others, interest, dividend. Ye sara kuch diya hai in the question, but we don't know the breakup between fire and marine. So these incomes which are given to us in the question will go to our profit and loss. So for now, income side pay, this is the only thing we have. Let us take the total. That will be the same, 3072.50 and 4920. Now let's go to our second schedule for claims. Now for claims, we have separately amounts for fire and marine. We have paid. We have what is closing outstanding and opening outstanding. So let us write that. Is bar there is no expenses related to claims. So paid during the year. To that we will add our closing outstanding. And from that we will subtract our opening outstanding. So let us see the amounts for fire first. Fire ke liye paid during the year is 800. Closing outstanding 31st March 592. And opening outstanding 1st April 300. Wo hum brackets mein likhenge. And same way let's do for marine. So marine paid is 1600. Closing outstanding is 920 and our opening outstanding is 240. Let's do this plus minus. 800 plus 592 minus 300. We get 1092. And 1600 plus 920 minus 240. We get 2280. No other adjustments. So we'll take this to our revenue. 1092 and 2280. Now we have to make our schedule for commission. Commission ke liye they've directly given us the amount. Seedha fire or marine, no adjustments. So I'll directly write the amount here. No need to make a separate schedule. So 648 and 540. 648 and 540. Then we have to make a schedule for our operating expenses, which is our schedule number 4. It's a small schedule. This time there is not much detail given for operating expenses. In fact, jo expenses of management bhi diye hai, they are common expenses like directors, remuneration, auditors, fees, etc. We don't know the breakup between fire and marine. There is only one expense jahan par we know the difference between the two, and that is bad debts. So that is the only expense which we will show in our operating expenses. So bad debts for fire is 18 and for marine is 48. So that is it. We'll take that to our revenue. 18 and 48. Let us take a total of all these three expenses. So 1092 plus 648 plus 18, we get 1758. And for marine, 2280 plus 540 plus 48, 2868. Let's find our operating profit. So 3072.5 minus 1758, 1314.50, and 4920 minus 2868, we get 2052. So this is our operating profit from each individual insurance business. But we still have to find our total profit for the company, which we will get from the P&L account. So first take all of this down, then we'll go to how to prepare the profit and loss account. So now I have made a P&L account format. So let's just run through the format quickly. Pehle we will start with the operating profit, jo hume revenue account se milega. Then we add the income from investment. Then we add any other income if we have that. Then from that income total, we have to subtract two things. One is provisions other than tax. Tax ke alawa aur koi provision kiya hai, like for depreciation, or maybe for bad debts, then that will come here. Other expenses, because yahan par we have a few other expenses, to maine space choda hai for writing that list. Then we get our profit before tax, we subtract our tax, and we get our profit after tax. So now let's begin with first bringing this operating profit from our revenue account to our P&L account. So for fire, it is 1314.50. For marine insurance, it is 2052. Now coming to income from investment, हमारे पास एक नंबर दिया है फॉर इंटरेस्ट डिविडेंड रेंट एटसेट्रा. दे हैव गिवन अस डायरेक्टली इंटरेस्ट एंड डिविडेंड 192. सो आई विल डायरेक्टली राइट दैट ओवर हियर. इफ वी हैव द नेट फिगर आफ्टर टैक्स, तो टैक्स ऐड करके यहां पर ग्रॉस अमाउंट लिखना है. ओके, प्रॉफिट और लॉस ऑन इन्वेस्टमेंट इज नॉट देयर. For our other income, we have around 3-4 things. So let us make a small working note for that, where we will calculate our other income. So let us see what we have in the question. First we have is difference in exchange, that is foreign exchange difference, and it's given as credit. The amount is 3.12. Then after that we have share transfer fees. I already explained what this is. ये income होता है for any company. So share transfer fees is 24.8. And we also have miscellaneous receipts. And that amount is 30. So now let's take a total of this and take it to our P&L. So 3.12 plus 24.8 plus 30, we get 57.92. Let's bring that over here. And now let us add everything together to get our total income. First total A. So 1314.5, 2052, 192 and 57.92. We have 3616.42. Now let's go to our expenses. Provisions other than tax, there is nothing. So I'll put a dash. In this other expenses, we'll make a list of expenses jo diye hain. So first is depreciation. Let's write that down. We don't know depreciation is on which asset. It's given as one amount 106. Then we also have auditor's fees and director's remuneration. So our auditor's fees is 7.2. And our director's remuneration is 30. And we don't have any other expenses. So this is it. So we will take a total of our expense side, which is including provision. But yahan par it is dash. So 106 plus 7.2 plus 30. We get 143.20. This is our total of expense. Now we subtract this. So 3616.42 minus 143.2. So we get 3473.22. Now we have to calculate our tax. Aur last line mein diya hai, provide tax at 30%. So 30% of what? 30% of your profit before tax. So into 30%, we get 1041.966. I'm rounding it off to 97. Let us subtract it. So 3473.22 minus 1041.97. We get our final profit for the company as 2431.25. So this is how you find the final profit by preparing profit and loss account. So till the last sum, we were doing only revenue accounts. Now we have gone one step further and we have also prepared our profit and loss account. So I hope you have understood this well. Take all of this down. We wind up this session over here. Thank you.